Alright, y'all, so I'm finally about to go pick up my barbershop. That's right, I'm gonna go pick up my barbershop because I'm finally done my mobile barbershop. This has been a project I've been working on for, I would say, over 8 months, like all in. Just like from acquisition to coming up with the design to finding the contractors to just, it's a lot. I ain't gonna lie, it's a lot of work, but for a lot of y'all are probably interested in the process, and I'm definitely going to release something for y'all later on and show y'all exactly, you know, how to navigate this, because it's not easy. I'm not gonna lie, this is probably one of the hardest things I've done as far as building something, you know. But I think it was smarter than getting a barbershop, honestly. And if you disagree, please tell me why, you know. And a lot of people say, you know, hey, you should get a barbershop first, then get a mobile unit. But with me, I feel like I just see a different path for myself. And I want to trailblaze my own path. I don't want to just do what every other barber does. You know, me being a young barber that's coming up in the game, I just feel like the mobile barbershop is the highest level that you can possibly attain. Because not only can you charge premium prices, you can make it more convenient for your client. You can make it more convenient for you. You don't have to be stuck at this one location all day. You know, you can move around. So I'm excited, man. And people probably asking, like, how much it costs. But it depends on, you know, the design. It depends on the material you source. It depends on a lot of different things. It's not going to just be one set price, you know. If somebody comes up with a system, which is something I'm working on, then it will be a set price. But I think being that it's such a freelance thing right now, there's a lot of different variables that can make your unit more expensive or cheaper, you know. And it depends on how you want to do it. It depends on which clientele that you want to attract to you. You know, I always say, the more money you put in is the more money you get out, you know. Mine wasn't cheap at all. Man, that's a lot, you know. But when you realize how money works, it's not a lot, man. Because this is an investment I'm gonna have for the rest of my life, you know, unless I decide to sell it and make a new one. I have endless amount of time to continuously make money. And sometimes people gotta realize, when you make investments, sometimes you gotta put a lot up in the beginning. But the way that rich people stay rich, they got a lot of money constantly coming in. It might not be the $1 million they put up to buy this property or whatever, but they give them cash flow $5,000 to $7,000 a month. That's longevity, and that's what you want. You don't always want this super big payday. You want to have longevity, constant money coming in. So that's how I looked about it, you know. That's how I looked at the whole thing, the whole process. So I'm excited, man. We're going to pick it up.
Ooh, hop in that motherfucking phone, and a motherfucker be wrong. Big gun, big yeah, Sean. City to city, I'm torn. Lacardi, I'm ready to pour. I love my diamond, that gone. Fuck with your bitch, yeah, she left in the morning. Diamonds that skating on ice.
Throw in I'll probably mount a vacuum, so just throw that shit in when I come back. That's all good, you know what I mean?
That's gonna give you a little more light.
Yeah. See, that's what I'm doing right now, so I can hardwire it straight white.
This is nice, babe.
This is super cool.
I like it.
Yeah, I like it.
Ooh, this is fancy.
Fancy, man. You know what I'm saying? Still juggling shit.
ahead and bolt it down. Right. So we'll make sure it does what you want it to do. Get a good grip on it. See what you want. All right.
This goes, I think this is what I'm supposed to put this right here, right?
Yep, that's what we'll do there.
So yeah, I mean, she's about average height. It's might get to scoot back a little bit.
That's what I'm saying. They might have to scoot back a little or down a little. Just.
Okay. So let's see if it turns. So I'll reset you.
This chair.
See how the clearance is. Yeah, I want to say it'll clear in that spot. So. Should be good. Yep, you're gonna clear.
Oh, so when you're going up, the lock's on, right?
Mm-hmm. Yep, it clears.
Yeah, that's fine. As long as this turns, they can keep their feet in.
Right side drill bit.
Watch your eyes.
That's nice, babe.
Yeah. Honestly, man, this has been a long time coming. I'm just really happy that it came out better than I thought. And I feel like they did a really professional job. Like, everything's clean, everything's level. It's very good lighting in here. Like, this is like the best part about, well, the hardest part about barbering is like trying to figure out your lighting. And it's very good lighting here. This is a little bit, I don't like that. But, the thing I like, they insulated everything too. So like when it gets cold in here, that's why it's staying cold.
You when it gets cold. Oh, okay.
Cause they put like insulation all in the walls. So like that's something I said I wanted for sure. But I'm just happy I got consulted by like people that have done it before me that kind of knew what they were doing. And I did a lot of research so I can make sure it come out correctly. And now I'm gonna do the same thing for y'all, man. Y'all tap in with me real soon. I'm gonna have a whole course for y'all so y'all can figure out how to get your very own mobile barbershop and start changing the game. This is the new standard. The pandemic happened, they shut down the shops. They can't shut us down when we mobile, man. So this is the new wave, this is the new standard right here. Y'all stay tuned, man. Kleangrooming, let's get it.